So art composers composing for business or for the church to assist in worship and praise?
I'm so glad someone's asked that. Because when I do a copyright workshop, one of the big things that I talk about is the myth that Australian composers are wealthy. And if you have a conversation with a handful of composers that are here, without exposing their personal financial details, which I don't really and privy to them, I know that the royalty, people think royalty is like thousands of dollars. One composer in the room earned, I think it was $4.18 last year for her works. Another composer in the room has never received any royalty for her works, although her work was used in the Wollongong Diocese significantly during World Youth Day, in the Rockhampton Diocese, in the Sydney Diocese, and has never received a royalty. So is it a mission? Is it a service? Is it a commercial thing? It is most definitely a mission. It is most definitely a service. And I get quite passionate and sort of emotional about this because, you know, people think that composers and publishers, I mean, people think I'm riding on the back of some fantastically beautifully gold-gilded wave, I think. You know, I was telling someone earlier that it took me 12 and a half years to pay off As One Draws. 12 and a half years to pay off the first edition. So, you know, like, there's a huge myth out there that, you know, we're all basking in this fabulous thing called royalties. And it's just nonsense, really. I wish it was otherwise.